Hello. Welcome to another of Stuart Wilde's Books on Tape. In this audio program, Stuart reads his book, Life Was Never Meant to Be a Struggle. Now here's Stuart Wilde.
Life was never meant to be a struggle, just a gentle progression from one point to another, much like walking through a valley on a sunny day. Chapter 1. The Stragglers' Hall of Fame. Do you remember as a child being told that if you wanted to make it in life, you would have to work hard, that life involved pain and struggle, that you would have to earn love and acceptance, and that you would have to put in an incredible effort just to come out on top? I certainly remember my mother saying to me, "Struggle ennobles the soul." Yet who says this is true? Look at nature. It expends a certain effort in sustaining itself, but it does not struggle. Does the tiger in the forest get up in the morning and say, "I'll struggle like crazy today, and hopefully by supper time I'll get something to eat"? No way. It just rises, has a little sniff under its tiger armpits, or does whatever tigers do at breakfast time, and heads out. At noon, there on the path is lunch, provided courtesy of the Great Spirit. Okay, the last 30 yards involves the tiger in a bit of rushing about, but that can hardly be construed as struggle. You too may have to cross town to pick up a check, but there's a great difference between struggle and effort. Our physical condition as humans involves effort, but struggle is effort laced with emotion and desperation. Think of this. If you accept full responsibility for your life, then you will accept that your destiny is created by you, and that your life is basically a symbol of your innermost thoughts and feelings, what you believe about yourself. Now, if over a period of years, you've laid down a couple of 100,000 thoughts in your subconscious that say, life is a struggle, then naturally you will project that from your inner feelings. Even if you are not necessarily consciously aware of that aspect of your inner self, the thought would still lay deep within you, and it would still show up constantly in your life. Whenever a project starts to flow too well, or things become too easy, your inner self emits an energy that says, "Warning, warning, this is too simple. Let us self-destruct this project or relationship and come at it the hard way, so that we can experience circumstances that are congruent with our inner belief that life is a struggle." So things fall apart, and you feel like you're trying to push a peanut up Everest with your nose. Eventually, once you've suffered the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune for a while, the inner self pulls to you a watered-down version of circumstances that would have been yours anyway, weeks ago, and without effort. This booklet helps you identify struggle, discover the reasons for it, and eliminate it. But first, let us look at some of the characters in the Stragglers Hall of Fame. I'm sure you will have fun recognizing them from among your friends and acquaintances.
The hero.
Men like struggling, but then so do some women. The male version goes something like this. If I bust a gut and hurtle around trying hard, people will see me as a good man, and they will treat me with respect. Whether I get results or not matters little as long as I'm seen to be making a valiant effort. To make sure everyone acknowledges my heroism, I will create an entire theater of frantic action, hectic schedules, meetings of earth-shattering importance, long hours, and constant pressure. Of course, this pantomime will make me a bit tense, but that is all part of the act, for the tension will be seen by others as my taking responsibility, and they will love and respect me for that, won't they?
If the truth be known, the answer is no.
In fact, anyone with any perception will see this male is a complete idiot. His weakness, namely, a lack of personal acceptance, stands out a mile. He has cast his fate to sacrifice in the hope of winning affection or acknowledgement. His frantic actions only serve to underline that he is out of control and does not really have a clue about what he is doing. Another common struggler is the terrorist type. This fellow, because he is uncomfortable with himself, finds that he is unable to deal with society. Either he was born disadvantaged, or he has never been accepted, or he bears a grudge of some kind. Because of this, he has to operate outside of society, and he finds it hard to accept anyone's help. He struggles through 101 projects that never quite come off. And even if he makes the success of a relationship or a project, it will seem to him a hollow victory. For what he wants is acceptance, not success. So he will usually self-destruct his successes and move on to struggling at something else. If the terrorist ever finds himself within the mainstream, for example, if he gets a job in a corporation, he will find fault with that situation, sneer at it and attempt to change or destroy it. Usually his actions will threaten those around him, and sooner or later he'll be tossed out. Because the terrorist has to fight the system rather than use it, he never gets what he wants. No one supports him. If he does find someone who loves and accepts him, he disregards that and focuses instead on all those aspects of non-recognition that are a part of his life. The third type of struggler is the professional wimp. This person is so weak and lacking in his ability to command life, he allows everyone to tow him around by the nose. It makes him angry and he will protest his rights from a position that he feels is logically just. Yet his struggle results from weak energy, and he gets nowhere and no one cares. There is a variation on this theme, the spiritual wimp. This character has a huge ego and feels that God dropped him off on earth so that he could sit around being special. He is usually so holy that he cannot soil his hands with life. He expects people to treat him like a god and honor him anyway. Usually he struggles like crazy, for people find it hard to accept his lifestyle and his failure threatens them. One of the common female archetypes,
the goddess,
is similar to the male. She plays a game called Please Accept Me, for I Am Great. I'm really a goddess, and I'm as strong, if not stronger, than any male. To act out her pantomime, she dresses up in male clothes, drives fast cars, gets super aggressive to make up for her lack of confidence, and she, too, hurtles out and plays the achiever's game of her male counterpart. In truth, being a goddess is hard work, for you constantly have to sustain a celestial pose. Usually others will not.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.